Okay. Shannon, what do you think this is? What is it? Okay, this is at the construction site. This is the bathroom. So it's good to be bad. It didn't smell. And when you look into the hole, it's very deep, so the nose, I don't know. I used it once. I mean, because it was there. A lot of times I didn't go for maybe 10 hours. It's so hot. It's so hot. I mean, you know, for me, I would go because it's there. Right? Oh, let's go. Over there, sometimes you don't know where the bathroom is. You don't know if there is one. So it's kind of like, okay, then what are we doing next? And I don't know, for me, I didn't really have to go for it, you know, but I went because it was there. Every year I got a pretty good different picture of the kids. Oh, you gotta remember this. They thought I was Jackie Chan. Only Asian around. They kept doing this. And you know what? I didn't tell them I wasn't. It was kind of cool. I forgot to mention when I first got to Haiti at the airport, there was a missing luggage. So we went, there was two other team members, which is the couple, the last minute couple. They were gonna come 4 hours later, so we went, instead of going 3 hours to Petit Guav, airport was in Port-au-Prince, so we decided to go around the corner to a restaurant, and we waited. So I'm going, what was in that bag? What was in that missing bag? And it was kind of a test where I got a little frustrated and worried that, what was in that bag? Okay, what am I going to do if we can't find a bag? You know. So we went back to the airport 4 hours later, and looking, and there was. And then I just thank God and I thank the person or the agent and workers. Okay, beautiful, beautifully done. I never saw it. John, beautiful. I got the rough draft of it. Oh, wow. Let's see, before I get to this, I'm reading my notes. There's a story about, I think it was the first or second day where I don't have a, we left the construction site. I don't know what we were doing, so we left, everyone left their camera, everything. So we walked 3 blocks, and there was like 100 pound cement bags in the tap. And we're going to carry it, let's say from here to the speaker there, maybe, you know, that far, 100 yards or whatever. But the only thing is, we had to step over muddy water, and it was like deep enough where to get your shoes all soaked. And then we had to like carry 100 pound bags on our shoulders and then step on bricks. So I'm going like this, 100 pound bags like this, balancing. And then there's 3 steps. And then you do one of those bags, drop it, and I'm going, nobody filmed this. Right out of a movie. Couldn't believe it. 7 bags, I was exhausted. I said, it's Coca-Cola time. Coca-Cola on me. Vacation Bible School. Okay, this is in a church. I think there are 60 kids in this. We were passing out, you know, coloring stuff. And of course, first thing we did was, you know, share the gospel with them. And most of them, or all of them, were already supposed to be saved, what I heard from the pastors. And if you look at that, that's what this church looks like. And all I guess a lot of churches know. What I found out was, like last year I said, pray that they don't run out of money to finish the church. Which is good. It's a good prayer, let's finish the church. But the thing I found out was, just because the church is not finished, doesn't mean they're not having church. Doesn't mean anything. But they still are. That's what's holding up the canvases or tops. You know, they need shade. Gotta have mine. And yeah, supposed to have 80% unemployment. But a lot of them are like out here selling stuff, and I do believe it's, you know, what do you call that? Microfinance, microloans. I think a lot of them, you know, that's how they get their stuff. And what I also heard, what I found out was, they have their own space. They go to the same space for some, you know, people know where their space is to sell stuff. They sell all kinds of stuff. You name it, they have it. But who can afford it? How many agents can actually afford to buy this? So who actually buys this? I don't know. Because they're so desperate for, like, yeah, Ginger and Chris bought like 75 shades and then to give away. None of them have shades. So yeah, they gave those away. And all the translators, even the pastors asked me for stuff. Like, hey, you got an extra cap? You got shades? You got a toothbrush? Everything, you know, and so we always have something to give them, so that's cool. There's another area where we need the VBS. This time we had 100 kids.